All right, so here we are, flying the A7He1, which is basically the HE-112B0 done up in Japanese livery. As far as War Thunder is concerned, anyway. Alright, so I'm gonna go due north. Well, not due north. West by northwest. And I'm gonna climb a little bit. I just played this match, or this map, my last match. A little bit different. I'm glad to see there's a. Starting to get some more variety on the Chinese front maps. Took a short break from playing War Thunder. Actually, playing from playing video games in general. Went to Yellowstone. Saw some bison. Saw some bears, elk, mule deer, bald eagles, animals. Geyser fields. Smelled rotten eggs. Bubbling mud. Pretty cool place. If you ever have the time, I highly recommend it. Did that on the first week of July, and the next week, and the 2 weeks following that, I just basically spent most of my time processing the images. I took about 2,000 to 2,500 pictures. Shot a good deal of video footage. I filled up a 64 gig SD card and a 32 gig SD card with the video and pictures I took. I've uploaded the videos. Some of you who actually, look at my channel or whatever, pay attention to it, might see that I had uploaded some videos of the bison and Yellowstone in general. Oh. Alright, got contact. I bet that's a friendly though. Just because he's getting shot at. Not friendly. So yeah, the first week after, or the second week of July, I spent most of my time editing images and video. Trip. And then the week after that, I just spent time vegging and deciding what to do about flight sims. And then I saw that War Thunder had decoupled flying simulator from the tank simulator, which makes me happy to an extent. It means I can I'm not stuck flying either Russia or Germany forever. I pretty much fly anything I want. Well, this guy over here, what are you? Good guy or bad guy? Let's go. Oh, he's a good guy. How about this guy? Bad guy. Uh-oh. Negative G's, really? Where'd he go? Okay, there he is. It's a big plane. Seriously, dude. Did it hurt me? I think I did. I need to go back to base. Yep. Yep. So, need to turn right. Got the hotkeys for that stuff. Wow. Oh, this is gonna be a rough landing. Lack of lift on my left. Sir. Did I not? Because my landing gear was broken. All right. Repairing! Gear up. Well, maybe I'll stay level. Get some dots off to my right here. Build up some speed. Tracers, Russians. Target selected. So, yeah, my flight controls. I had them nailed to a board that was went over my lap like a TV dinner tray kind of thing. I changed it around so that it's a, and I nailed my, basically nailed my controls to the bottom, or on top of a board that runs underneath my legs. Ah, crap. Chasing the wrong guy. So, now what the, what that does is it brings the controls down to, I'm gonna stall. Lowers the controls. Whereas before they were too high. Where'd he go? And basically now the base of my controls are about even with my thighs, just below the top of my thighs. There. Got teared up. This basically puts the controls at a more, I guess you could call it a more correct level, although since the stick isn't between my legs, it's not really correct for a World War II plane. Although it is more accurate for something like a F-16 simulator. Guy left. I think that's him right out there. I thought I saw something. Okay, maybe not. In general, it's a more comfortable stick position. More comfortable position for flight controls. Off to either side of my legs. And at about armrest height, basically, is where the hand control, where my hands sit on the controls. And only one of him, so I need to check him out.